everyone, welcome to the very first episode of Thoughtfully Made, a podcast in which I explore my wardrobe efforts in sewing, knitting, spinning, all the fibery things. My name is Amy. I've been sewing for about 4 years, and I've been knitting for about 3. Spinning I just took up seriously recently. So I just thought I'd create a little podcast just to talk to you all about some of the things I've been doing, steps that I'm taking towards a more sustainable and self-made wardrobe. I've been wanting to, really craving in this pandemic, to talk to people in person, face-to-face, about fiber arts. I really miss that yarn shop in-person connection, and I've been really enjoying all the wonderful podcasts out there available on the topic, so I thought I would join in on the fun. So without any further ado, let's get started. Let's get started with what I'm wearing. So I am wearing a sweater called the Atlantica sweater. I'm gonna get up so I can show you. It is a wonderful lace pattern with a drop shoulder sleeve that falls about halfway on my shoulder, like so. It is a full length pullover. And definitely the star of the show is all of this wonderful texture, which is created by bobbles. You can see some of them here. And the lace eyelets and twisted one by one cable stitches. I knit it in one strand of Woolberry Berry Mohair in the colorway A Single Pearl. And I also held it with one strand of Knerd string fingering. I think it's in their colorway Tidal Pool. The materials were provided to me by a yarn shop in Colorado called Fancy Tiger Crafts. And while this video is not sponsored, I did receive those materials in exchange for a blog post and some Instagram posts. So I'll put the link to the blog post below, and you can read all about it. The original pattern does call for 2 strands of Lopi, and I started to knit it with Lopi provided by them, and I ran into some pretty grody hand paint issues, and I think that it's because there's not much crimp to the fiber, and there was just not enough stretchiness and bounciness in it for my style of knitting. And with the chronic pain flare-up, I just felt that I needed to switch gears, so I went ahead and swapped the yarn out, and I'm really happy with the results. I think the lace is just so effective and so beautiful, and I did do some mods, so if you want to know all about this piece, you can go ahead to the blog post below, and you can read all about it in the blog. So I wanted to start first with some works in progress. So I guess this is like my most recent finished object, and I'll get to more finished objects soon, but let's do some work in progress. Let's see, what do I have here? I have a sock in progress. So this is the Briarfield Lane Socks. I am test knitting it for Autumn and Indigo. I'll put a link to her work below, but it will not be out for a while. And I have received permission to share works in progress, but it's a simple little sock with a slip stitch heel, although I'm modifying that. It has this beautiful little lace panel down the front. Let me try to stick my hand in it so you can see the lace. Here we go. Gorgeous little lace panel. I think the original sock pattern is knit in her local fingering yarn. And this one I've knit up in Woolberry Fiber Co. In the colorway Sting. It was from the Lord of the Rings Club that she did last year, and I believe she just did some pre-orders for it too. And it's just this most lovely, wonderful little subtle variegated semi-solid color. I'll show you the back so you can see the color. It's really lovely. So So that's kind of what I'm working on test knitting wise. And on the needles, I also have Brooklyn Tweed's Shelter. I'm knitting up Jared Flood's Galloway sweater, and I've got two sleeves so far. So I initially swatched in different colors and I didn't like it. And I ended up switching up the color game. And then I knit the sleeves first as kind of like a new swatch situation. And the sleeves are done. So I've done it in these colors. Ooh, let's see if I can remember the colors. The white one is like this really beautiful flecky heathered white. It's called Fossil. The blue is Tartan, and I don't know if you can see how beautifully heathered and complex these colors are, but I really enjoy them. And this red color is Embers, and the yellow is the one I replaced after swatching. This is Bale. So all the other colors other than Bale I purchased last year during their Sapore local yarn shop sale, and I have been letting it languish in my stash since. So I'm making an effort to knit it up. I've got two sleeves so far, and I've got part of the body, the very start of it. So I'm just in the middle of the color work section there. It has a tubular cast on, and I am modifying it. It has this big wide triangle crossover front situation, but because it's knit up at a, you know, like relatively tight gauge to me, 20 stitches full worsted, over 4 inches, over 10 centimeters, I wanted it to have a closer fit. I wanted it to have more buttons down the front, but keeping the V-neck. So I modified it to be kind of a straight, I just worked the math for the armpit number of stitches in the body in my size, and instead of casting on more stitches and decreasing towards that armpit stitch count, I just cast on that stitch count. And then I had to shift the start of the colorwork pattern to get it symmetrical. So that's what I've got going on. It's knit in the recommended yarn, Brooklyn Tweed Shelter. And I'll put links below everything. And I've got these pretty little stitch markers. These were a gift from Lindsay at Artifacts of Appreciation. She also has a podcast. These were gifts given to me last year by her, and they're so lovely. I actually bought more. But that's what is going on there. Very lovely. I got a pretty good deal during the sale on them. I've been wanting to knit this for a long time, so let's see if I can finish it. Alright, so that's another one of my current knitting objects. And let's see, what else am I working on? I am also working on, I have so many like in progress things going on right now. I've got this next project from Fancy Tiger Crafts that I'm working on for their vlog. And it looks like this so far. So right now it's just a tube. It's in a brioche stitch. But what I love about it, and what I've never seen before, is it's knit in two color brioche, which is new to me. But what's even more exciting to me is that it's knit in one worsted and one lace weight yarn, which creates such an interesting, like semi-see-through yet chunky brioche pattern. It's plush, like all brioche. It's very like squishy, but it's got some breathing room in there, doesn't it? Lends like a sense of mystique. The yarns I am using, because I want this to be like kind of a spring pullover, I'm planning to knit the elbow length. The yarns I am using, I wanted it to be kind of next to skin soft, so I've got a full skein here of Woolfolk Far, which is an ultra fine merino. It's something like 18 or 19 micron count, just so soft. One of my favorite yarns. It has an interesting chainette construction. Oh, just so pretty. I'm using it in the natural color 00. So in my size, the medium size, it's just gonna be three skeins of the Woolfolk, and then one ball, which is already in ball form, one skein of the lace weight yarn, like a 50 gram, I think, skein. This one is a Surrey alpaca base, and it is dyed by the farmer's daughters. This is their Odane base. And I have it in this gorgeous little complex brown neutral. This color is called Paul Newman. Very fluffy, very, very squish-worthy. Everything about this fabric is just, I think the drape is gonna be really nice. So I cannot wait to finish that. All right, and my last whip that I'm willing to share right now, because I have so many, is a spinning whip. I have been trying to learn to spin over the past few months. I got my wheel, which is an Ashford traditional. I think it's back there, you can kind of see it. I got it in October from a woman in my local guild who's really lovely. And I've been experimenting with different fibers, and I just fell in love with this beautiful camel silk. I've got it in like a partial braid here, but you can see all these gorgeous colors. This is dyed by Greenwood Fiberworks, and it is 50% baby camel and 50% silk. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm distracted by how soft and plush it is. You can see the ends here. It's so soft. I am spinning it on the fall, semi-worsted. And I've already spun up a whole bobbin of it. An entire bobbin. So this is kind of like that bluish section. But my favorite part is when it transitions. And sadly, for now, that's like under this part. So hopefully I'll make some progress on this. This bobbin took me like 6 straight days of intensive, my foot hurts kind of spinning. It was quite a slippery yarn, so I find myself kind of taking my time with it. And I'm hoping to knit a beautiful kind of light fingering lace weightish shawl with it. So that's my one spinning whip. All right, what else? And I think that's all my works in progress that I was planning on sharing today. Yeah, it is. It is. How exciting. All right, so now we're going to go on to my other finished object. I guess I have blue on my mind because after I knit this sweater, which took me like 3 months to do, I still wasn't feeling done with that color. So I dug into my stash and found this gorgeous yarn. This is from a Christmas set by Woolberry. Fibercone. This is their berry sock set. I think it's 80% merino, 20% nylon. And I knitted up in this Vervain sock by Sachiko Burgin, I think is how you pronounce her name. The pattern is available on her site, and I'll link it below. And it has this gorgeous lace panel. Lace panel socks are really my jam, you can probably tell. And my favorite part is that the lace panel runs all the way down the rib. All the way down. And it's flanked by the rib all around. And it just creates just this most delightful little sock. These knit up so quick because I find lace panels just really hard to put down when I knit it. I just keep going like one more row. I wanna see what happens next. So I finished these in like 5 days. Went pretty well. These will keep me cozy. This year I'm really trying to stash down some of my superwash sock yarns because I have so much that it overwhelms me. I was in the Woolberry Lord of the Rings club last year, and it's something like 18 skeins of sock yarn. So I have a lot to stash down, and I'm kind of making my way through that right now, and this was part of that effort. Even though this is just part of the Christmas collection. So I already had this yarn before the club. So I think that's all the finished objects I have to share. And finally, I wanted to give kind of the details of my upcoming knit along. Starting today, which will be Tuesday, when you see this, Tuesday, March the 2nd, I will be running a knit diverse knit along. Part of kind of my intention as a maker is to support other makers in communities that are historically under-recognized and under-resourced. There's so many makers that I feel the Instagram and Ravelry algorithms kind of bury, who are people of color, who are people who are part of the queer community, of the LGBTQIA community, which I feel the Instagram algorithm does not adequately compensate for. So in the next couple weeks, over on my Instagram, @AmyShureMakes, I will be sharing links to various makers who I find really inspiring. There'll be sewists and knitters and designers and yarn dyers and notion makers to supply all your crafting needs. And we will be casting on mid-March, the third week of March, and I will have some giveaways and prizes for works in progress, just so we can celebrate these wonderful, diverse makers and be a little more intentional together. I'm hoping that it helps us build a little community, and hopefully you'll discover some makers you haven't seen before. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what you all make with that. If you enjoyed this episode, please do subscribe, and I hope to see you back here soon. I'll insert some footage now of myself doing a little spinning, a little knitting, and hope that you'll find it nice and relaxing. And again, my name is Amy, and thank you for joining me today, and hope to talk to you soon.